Hello, we have been here a vlog time again for a cricket week. Ugh. Okay then. The first I'm going to tell you is the Kobayashi written by Jake Fujinko. In this episode, go basically, Chachi Parrot don't actually know that she is a part time psychic. When every episode, they find out and they don't like it because they don't want her to do it again. So that's the big episode. When it's very much a fact of that actually literal people, circle burble, where, you know, they went to Gosh character a bit and Fire Parent and stuff like that. But, you know, the episode very much deeper into that. Yeah, pretty good. You know, I like Furlberg more, but they're going to that point in on a cycle shake guy, like, I kind of have that point, like, you know, like, an episode where, I don't know if you want stuff I've seen before, where I don't know, find out that, like, a character has done some stuff and they don't want them to do it anymore, like, give me a second. Anyway, yeah. I don't know how common it is, but like somewhere. Okay, but it does on pretty well, just that it would be that you know that they're good, you know, they're not gonna do all the costumes, they'll find a way to get the paratone down upon the Robins and yada yada. But it does on pretty well, I think. I feel like it can become, it seems like every time I complain with you got Gosh, you know, some of that being funny, they bring up, like, this fat very much focused on her big time. You know, oh, one thing mentioned that my friend first episode, her dad was versus to gay, and this episode, they get into cave and line. It's in a somewhat discreet way, I think, but he's not getting it. You know. Right, it's like every time, you know, Freebird, Kubo, you know. I think particularly Bungar and Kubo, Freebird is like, you know, at this point, why not? It'll get near the end anyway. But anyway, it's not one more true waking guy, but like, yeah, okay, you had to get out of your system. I don't know if they didn't for them, but I don't think they did. And they literally go back to the Furgleburg world, except they don't bring in the Furgleburg. Go, you're out of 10, or don't go. Yeah. Anyway, quick episode, it's definitely more enjoyable from Joe Focolo. There's definitely some. I like how ripped in the episode can get going, Dad. It's just the regular guy in the world, which is cool. And he got more competent, apparently. And the part was really gonna play in class with that weird dude, that one weird dude, physical time, who had been here, you know, not in the foreground. That's pretty funny. And that particularly joke for a couple of people, again, the one that are very rare, very rare. And like, again, I feel like the heart definitely carries one beyond the comic book element, so, yeah, interesting. Yeah, you know, Kasi gets to be pretty cool in the couple, but again, go back, yeah, but again, so, No, I don't know what to do, okay? Again, it's cause again, like, again, the previous episode, Nashi, you know, again, that kind of regular change to the group because the parents don't know that, and now we do, and they really like her now, so. Yeah, it was cool. First of all, we go back to a few different roles in this one, but at the beginning, get this go, it gets right when they need them to be in a certain world, but they don't. Because it's only gonna be a plot line, they don't know, okay, do one, going to go after the one. I can't complain when they try it out for a new class, and can't see if we got the clown roll again. But again, I think go back to our big flashy folk up code. Still my favorite. And then they show that wizard world that we got a couple of days ago, pretty recently. Because I knew that could be the blue wizard, and be fair, Gashi go. Okay. Again, these world goes in danger. Save the world. Yeah, it was good. Then finally, for the world class Star Trek world, of course, it's K-pop going. And for them, I'm not finally about that there, because I have Star Trek up, because it's a good for me, Star Trek. Yeah, pretty good. Yeah, that's all I'm not gonna tell, and it'll go around my neck. Good, it's not close shaking it, but it's okay, it gives me. Very good because of what the heart and bond, and again, the jokes that they do tell. So, yeah, thank you all guys for coming, honestly, because again, I am just an account for when I need to, but still, it's a pretty good episode. So, lots of you for the one in the second. Okay, and now for our thing of today, which Ethereal Fugitive went by Pat. Get a better name! Goddamn. I mean, that's what I pronounce, but I don't care. I'm planning on calling him. What do you call him that from now on? Go, 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 time we are back to the serial world where they are all serial mascots of a bunch of punkins. Another word, food fight, but funny. Potentially, I couldn't get from serial mascots and stuff. Go with one relatively straightforward sequel, basically, when they. Yeah, they're, the milkman who's with the power break down jam and tea. Ben and Larry are heading off to train in order to steal the Choco trunk. But a cracker turned out that McMahon and Dark walking on, they have Booker playing in mind. Kind of really simple to go following up on that first one, but I don't manage to really like it that bad. But that one, because it's more original, I like it a little more. But, yeah, I think they put a lot of good jokes in. They, while well, I can't even look in copy form, but a lot of fun jokes, like, Vic and Larry, a parody of Kenny Macock, who are all crazy. Banana, looking for banana brand, or something like that. apparently, Vic's getting really interrupted by a few commercials. Oh, community. That began stuff like that happens. This one gets him because, like, we don't go to focus more on Ben and Larry. You know, focus on them and how they are featured and again, them because they are fracking down. Act up now, trying to dedicate them. Probably the last time that it'd be like a pen book message would kind of there and a couple jokes at the moment. But nobody's going to trip and Larry to the point where I just gave a day in the end. Go. Quite cool. And if not, you know, I have no particular team on what I can be my girl, come on, my doing for more. But that one's still better. You know, it was just a fun episode because Palmer could even more to do because, you know, he'd been even more evil. So it was a lot of fun stuff in there with him. Yeah. Again, it gets me that scared again, game you already got going. I'm finally gonna think better here, slash, in that virtual episode. he's fun there too, though. Yeah, I'll still look up because probably of all single episodes, this one's most straightforward, I think. No, probably good, you know, they're being featured now, they're doing the bad stuff, you know. But you go to up, which might break the vertical more of a thing, again. Okay, well, but can have a lot of good jokes and a lot of cool moments too, like with Larry. The end. It's just a pretty fun episode. It's all kind of cool, hard to explain why I like it to the extent I do, because I do really like this one. And enjoy it a little more than the Kobayashi, given by the fact that I'm probably just a little bit better. It's cool, like a bubble code, but they put in a lot of fun joke into it to make it enjoyable without practicing. I guess it's not necessarily a plot, but what you do with it. The plot is kind of weak on that episode because it's pretty simple and straightforward compared to the other two episodes, but. It totally got worse for what it is, and it was very fun and enjoyable, so, yeah, both of them were really good, and even if I had nothing good, I just wanted to go get fair chat, straightforward, back up for the Capcom Kobayashi. Both pretty fun episodes, one too much story focused, one more comedy focused, one full of story. getting the vote for the great welfare they're trying to do. Very entertaining. They've not got much of a game, although it does seem like people have been crossing a big group of skies and told them to require them to be more major, which, okay, I don't know how flies and new women felt like what they did better, but if Gung Ho Rip and Larry are giving them a few, and we got a couple of good moments to go. And back before making Gosh TV, yeah, we could go, I feel like we got our film, and we got to come up Boone and Pinto up there too, go. Okay then, so tomorrow, the last Mountain Beast, and that could be a 22-minute affair, so, woohoo. Okay, gonna be like, in the end, I'll go, that first thing had a free in the middle of it, that would, I didn't think of it, so, based on the economic condition, I can give you a lot of plots of it, and go. That should be fun. Didn't have a lot of skate to go this session, but, oh well, hopefully I'll have more skate tomorrow based on that. But I can find that in a 22-minute affair. So, I shall see you all then for the end of week 2. Goodbye.